The narrative of American culture and identity is one that is Christian, white, heterosexual. What else would we say? Throw in some more. We could apple pie. Never,
suburban.
yeah.
Suburban.
Yeah. Suburban. Some would say suburban.
Middle
class. Can I throw white in again? Yeah. Yeah, and very white. Yeah.
People don't know that muhajibas, women who wear hijab, listen to music and speak English, and, you know, like boys, you know, and people don't know that some Muslim guys like dating white women who aren't Muslim. What's the code word for people in mainstream? White people, thank you.
Okay, so I have an interesting story with Hollywood. I just came back from Hollywood 2 weeks ago, where I went to my first Hollywood party, and I think they thought I was the kid from Slumdog Millionaire. And everyone gave me like two double looks, and then they figured out I wasn't him, and then no one talked to me, which was interesting. But to bounce off of Reza's point, I think you have to realize both in New York in the theater world and in Hollywood, the movie world, the color that ultimately matters is green. And what they want to see is, how can we market and sell your product? Now, the thing is this, if I may be blunt at Commonwealth, some of us who are considered ethnic, it's a code word for not white. Okay, and mainstream is a code word for white. Okay, so sometimes Hollywood has said to me and some other people here, how can your very ethnic story be, you know, relatable to the mainstream audience? Translation, you have brown people in your play. White person in Midwest might be terrified by brown people. And so that's something that my white
people.
Yeah, that's something that my white artists, friends, filmmakers never ever get asked. Ever. Even though we live in a globalized world. It's interesting. And so sometimes you need like someone like Zoe, like I call her like the Daywalker Blade, the one who works like you know, because sometimes I feel like you need someone like a translator, right? Like our stories need someone who, we need a filter to translate it. So a story about that is a producer in Hollywood loved the play, a white guy, really nice. And I think it's not born from malice. I think it's cultural ignorance, which hopefully we could talk about later. It's not malice or racism. I think it's just cultural ignorance. And he says, hey, I love the play. Who are we going to cast as the Pakistani immigrant father? And I'm like, I don't know. How about a Pakistani actor? He goes, I have an idea. I'm like, who's your idea? Ted Danson. And so I started laughing, and I'm like, that's hilarious. And there was silence on the phone line, right? And his reasoning was, he goes, America likes Ted Danson. He's safe. And I said, you can cast Ted Danson when I could get cast as Abraham Lincoln. But that just, though, that's a different conversation altogether.
Well, I think, you know, this has happened with other ethnic groups,
yeah, of
you
course.
Know, where, you
of
know,
course.
Chinese people are suddenly mm-hmm. David
Everyone.
Carradine or, mm-hmm. you know, I mean, it's not uncommon.
We're not unique.
I think. Yeah, exactly.
You're not unique as a minority.
Yeah, exactly. Right. Well, this,